We're going to solve Project Euler problem 27 using Haskell. The problem is the following one. Consider formulas of this type right here, n squared plus an plus b. Now some of these equations are prime generating equations, which will produce a larger amount of prime numbers for values of n starting with n equals 0. And our task is to find the values a and b with absolute value of a less than 1000 and absolute value of b less or equal than 1000, such that the longest streak of prime numbers is produced with n starting at 0. Okay, so let's begin. As you can see, I already have something in my source file, which is the prime generating function which we used in problem number 10. This will give us a list of prime numbers very efficiently. I modified it in such a way that it will actually give us a set of primes back, because that's more useful to us now. And in this set there are all the primes between 1 and 10 million. All right, so let's define a function streak length, which will take the values a and b and return the length of the streak that is produced by the formula with values a and b. So streak length a b is equal to, well, we have to apply the formula that is given to us, which is the following one. An n maps onto n squared plus a times n plus b. And we apply this to all the integers. All right, so now we want to find out, oh, sorry, we start at zero, of course. Now, of course, we will need to find out how many of these values n produce primes that are start from zero. So what's the longest streak starting from zero? How long does the predicate is prime hold for these numbers? So we can model this with take while. And then we need some kind of function that tells us is prime. Of course, we don't have a is prime function defined right here, but we can do so very efficiently by just checking if a number is an element of this set of primes. That's why I chose a set and not a list, because in a set, lookup is O of log n, while in the list it is O of n. So we can do this more efficiently using s.member primes. Yeah, I call it primes. Now this will give us the first values for which the function produces primes starting from zero, and we want to know how many of them are in this list. So we can just take the length. Okay, now that we've done this, we can define the main function. And we want to do the following one. We need to check values of a and b that we will check for their streak length. Now, how would we do this? Well, our a obviously must have an absolute value of less than 1000, which means that it can start at negative 999 and will go up to 999. B, on the other hand, we could in principle check every value of b, but we are not going to do that because it's very inefficient, And if you take a close look at this equation right here, consider the situation when n is equal to 0. When n is equal to 0, then this term will produce a 0, this term will produce a 0, and we're left with a single b. So in order for that to be prime, of course, b needs to be a prime. So actually, we only need to check prime values for b. We only need to let b iterate over prime values. So we're going to do it like that. We have already have a set of primes, and we are going to take the ones that are less than 1,000. So s dot filter, going to filter the set according to if they are less or equal than 1,000. Actually, of course, there's no prime that is equal to 1,000, so that doesn't really make a difference. And we want it as a list. All right. So now we're iterating over values of A, over values of B. And what will this produce? Well, the task is, or better to say, if we take a look at the problem again, then the exact question states that we need to find the product of A and B. So that's what we are going to do. We are going to save a tuple, first of all, of A times B, which will be the result that we submit to Project Euler. And we also need to store the streak length of A and B. Okay. So now we have all the streak lengths for values A and B. Now we need to find the maximum. The maximum value by the streak length. So we're going to achieve this by calculating maximum by and then doing this comparing the second element. Of course, for that we need to import data.list. List not qualified, and we need to import data.ord. Data.list is necessary for the maximum by function, and data.ord is necessary for the comparing function. Okay, now that we have the maximum, we can just print it out. All right, so let's go ahead and compile this. Comparing, of course, not comparing. It compiles, let's run it with time. And as you'll see, this first element of the tuple is our answer. Thanks for watching.